So welcome back to my channel. It is the day before show day. 4:45, we're about to get our first layer of tan. At this point, it's no deodorant from here. Final shower, final hair wash. Things are about to get very, very real. So yeah, I will see you after the first layer of tan is on. So first day of tan is all on. A big thank you to Nicola, who always does an amazing job with the tans. So from here, depending on if this goes a little bit patchy, which it can be with my skin, I may shower in the morning and then I will be having my second layer of tan tomorrow. But it's all very real now, very, very real. I do need a bit of a wee, so I have a slight water baby going on. Very, very real, and I'm very excited. I'm not worried about that. The tan's so much darker than it was last
night. Right. Are you cool with that? There we go. Much better.
Loads better.
Keep going, yeah.
That
tag is
well
where her walk on.
I've had
to
lift
the legs. Yeah. Pop that glue. There we go.
So it is now 10 o'clock. I still have Vicky here, who checked in on me this morning, just wanted to say hi and give a little bit of an update on things this morning. How are you feeling in terms of how I'm looking?
Oh, terrible. So she's stressing, she looks dreadful, she's watery. So there's everything to worry about. Hence the reason why I'm sat here like this. The thing is, right, is that a lot of people on show day stress, and this is the reason why I am here, because Ali does not need to stress. It was the same in 2019. You don't even feel like you're on prep, right? Or you certainly don't feel like it's show day.
No.
So it gets to that point where it's like, I don't even feel like it's show day, so maybe I should be stressing because it's show day. And I'm like, hey, you just need to just kind of curl up, which she is doing.
Curled up.
Curled up, cold because tan. But she's had her food, we've had a look at her. I had a look at her over FaceTime. And I just basically wasn't happy about just leaving it there, so before she ate anything, so I just came over to obviously have a look at her at that point. I'm very pleased with everything. She goes to bed a little bit watery, wakes up nice, dry and crispy and tight, which is wonderful. This is a terrible angle for me, by the way. Need to sort that out, because jacked. obviously, you know I'm an arsehole. But yeah, so realistically now, it's just about cruising into the next kind of hour or so, just nice and relaxed, and I'm gonna go for a walk, Ali's gonna get her shit together, and then we're gonna head off for athlete registration.
Yeah, and then from there, back here, makeup, chill, and then we'll be heading off to the venue for my second layer of tan, and then the show starts at about 12:30, so we'll just be watching that and just not doing a lot. Because this is as exciting a show day gets. Small, frequent meals, nothing big, trying to keep my waist nice and tight. But yeah, keeping warm and keeping my feet up.
And keeping water in.
Yeah, no,
not
like
cutting water.
No.
So people who'd start messaging saying, when are you cutting water?
Oh my God, you're still drinking.
Oh my God, you're still drinking. Like what?
Yeah.
Muscles need to be full. Muscles have water. I'm fucking dehydrate. Sorry, can I even swear on that? It might have to bleep that out.
So I will catch up with you guys when we are at the venue for check-in. Why is my face frozen? So a massive shout out to Kitty, my cousin, for doing my show day makeup. Very, very happy. We're just heading back to the venue now for the second. second layer of tan, and then we will just be there and chilling. So obviously I've got all of my stuff, and we've got a car full of supporters, and it makes me feel incredibly grateful that I have all these people rooting for me. So yeah, now is the fun bit. All of the work is done. There's literally nothing else that really can be done at this point other than enjoy it, keep my feet up, relax, smile, keep my headphones in, and just be present.
Salt vinegar crisps.
Salt vinegar crisps?
And we
oh yeah.
Salt vinegar crisps backstage.
Alcohol.
All the alcohol.
All the shit.
We are all ready, tan is on, makeup is on, jewellery, bikini, everything is on and ready. I'm just actually backstage with my headphones in. I find for me this is perfect. I like to kind of be on my own, no stress, no people, no talking, no distractions, and just kind of prepare myself and to be very present. So I'm just gonna show you guys a little bit of my physique and then run through some poses, make sure I'm happy, and then we have the interval coming up, and I will be on. Just saying, I'm now the same colour as Mum.
Not a chance.
Just chilling out. Nothing to do except sit off of my legs and chill. And that's it. Not long now.
Looking good.
Ali Lantos and Amanda Summers. And please face forward, ladies.
Go on, Ali!
You got this! Woo!
Okay, ladies, that concludes the judging of your division. Can I ask you to separate into your two groups and go back onto the lines that you occupied? Take a corner turn to your right.
Come on, help!
Okay, ladies, turn and face forwards. Hold it just there so we can just look again.
Nice!
Nice! Your call outs. This is your open. Oh!
Come on, Ali!
Nice! Big shoulders!
Take a quarter turn to face the rear of the stage, please.
Nice, Ali!
Nice! You got it!
Nice.
Woo!
Okay, number 56, could you go back in line for me, please? Number 54, likewise, could you go back in line, please? Number 59, back in line, please.
There we go!
Woo!
57, could you go back in line,
please? Take your time! There we go! Good job. Go! Yeah.
Hi, woo! Go on, Ali!
Yes! Wide! Nice!
Lovely!
Lovely!
Yes!
Thank you, Ali.
Good girl.
Woo!
And the invitation to the finals. Second place goes to number 51, Amy Holland.
Yes, Ali!
Which leaves your winner, first place, receiving the gold trophy and the title of Southern County's Ladies Bikini Champion for 2021.
You mean again?
Number 59, Ali Lantos. And ladies and gentlemen, please, please give it up for the ladies that didn't quite manage to crack the place and get the memo there. Grab each other's hands and lift them up in the air. That's what a loft means. Thank you very much, ladies. Thank you.
Congratulations, Vicky.
Oh, no. Now, our top three favourite photo for the camera. Oh, no. Favourite pose. And just the winner now on her own. Thank you, ladies. We hope to see you in the finals. Your ladies' bikini champion for 2021. Ali Lantos, ladies and gentlemen. Much improved from the last outing.
Instagram.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I told you were perfect, didn't I?
Post competition, what is happening?
Well, we have some first place. Mom and dad are fed.
There's only so much my mum can do.
Mate, I'm going to have 100 grams of cream of rice with blueberries and four lints.
I've only got a new car for this, right?
Yeah, check that out. And we are looking.
It's crispy.
just wanted to say my phone has been given off absolutely non-stop. It really means absolutely. I've been blown away by the amount of messages I've had. For now, I'm going to chill, be present, and enjoy my food. So yeah, I will catch up with you in the morning. So what has happened? So today we went back and we won the UKDFBA Southern Bikini for the second time, which was ridiculous. This time it was even better because I had my family and Louis and my cousin, and it was just very... It was like a perfect show day. Of course, Vicky was there as well. And yeah, everyone was, it was just nice to have people there for you. So I got called out into center stage. I wasn't moved. So for those that don't know bodybuilding, center stage being first position, and then outside of that is second and third and fourth and fifth. I was called out center stage. We did a few rounds of quarter turns. I wasn't moved. They then did a second call out, which I wasn't in, and then I did my individual routine, and I had a lot of nodding heads from the judges, which is always really positive. And then I was called to first place. I think more than anything, it was a sense of relief. I did feel a bit of pressure this year after winning the show in 2019. Go and win it again. So the first thing I felt was relief, I think. But yeah, I did have a judge actually say as I left that I was much improved from 2019, which is massive because, you know, in this sport you have to improve every time you stand on stage, otherwise what are you doing in your off season? Then had another judge saying that he uses me as a standard for bikini when he's judging, which was to me probably the biggest kind of compliment. And he just, you know, said how impressive my shape was with my taper. And, you know, for a judge to actually come and find me to tell me that was really special. And it's been a bit of a scary prep. It's just a very different prep, quite hard. Had to diet harder than I did in 2019 for a number of reasons. So to get that sort of feedback, it was just, made it all worth it.
It was a long prep.
Yeah, it was. This is just show number one of four, so we are now on to the next one. We have 2 weeks until Two Bros.
You know what you've got to do.
Yeah, and we basically just got to come in leaner, harder, but I'm ready. Just wanted to thank Louis for just putting up with me. People know how hard this is, and
it is definitely...
She's probably the easiest girl to do a prep with, so I don't know why she's thanking me. It's probably the easiest, it's probably just like she's been on an off season. Just a bit grouchy, but...
But thank you ever so much for everyone that has taken the time out to message me today. Even if it's just a small message, it really does mean a lot. And I was totally overwhelmed by the amount of messages and support I've had. It doesn't go unnoticed, and it makes this whole thing easier. Like, especially when people are behind you. Support. Yeah, it's crazy.
And it's amazing because she's actually replying right now to people.
Yeah, I've literally...
Rather than waiting for a couple of days. She's really, really happy, so she's going to reply to everyone now.
Yeah, before I even had my celebratory cream of rice, I did sit down and respond to every message, and they are still coming in as we speak. It's just ridiculous. I can't believe it. I had my massive bowl of cream of rice, which was only 100 grams, with some blueberries and about 6 Lindt chocolates in it. That's it. Genuinely, I haven't really been hungry. I've just been thirsty because my water was not a lot today. So I'm genuinely gonna have some more water and just relax and take the rest of my makeup off and get a good sleep. But this was, you know, the starting point for this year. So
a very good outcome for the first
Yeah,
it
couldn't have gone any better.
So we just keep momentum.
Absolutely.
I got faster than pulling.
Give me a sec. Give us a sec.
So we sat on this very, very wet bench this morning. It's obviously the morning after the show. And how are we feeling? I'm feeling very tired.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling very tired. My body feels quite sore, obviously being on stage for... How long was I on stage for?
A good 20 minutes,
which doesn't sound like a long time, but for a bodybuilding stage, it's a decent amount of time. Did make us work quite hard, lots of quarter turns. So yeah, my body's a bit sore this morning. My stomach, hunger, digestion, whatever the hell you want to call it, I feel fine. As you probably saw, I had just like a big bowl of cream of rice with some chocolate. I didn't eat anything off plan like crazy because obviously I'm still on prep. I feel really, really glad that I did that. You know, I haven't woken up and felt sick or anything like that. I just had a hell of a lot of carbohydrates last night, basically, from a source that I've been eating for the entire prep. So we've just kind of come out for a little bit of a walk, get some fresh air, reply to some more messages, and speak with Vicky as well, kind of find out what the plan of action is today. I don't think I'll be training at all, but I just want to know what's happening in terms of food. Obviously, with us still being at the Airbnb, we can still stay on track. You know, this is not an excuse to have an interesting day and eat off plan just because we can't be bothered to prep food. We're gonna prep food, whatever that may be, and just keep the day ticking on as normal. It's probably the first show I've woken up from, and apart from my body just feeling sore, I felt really good. No kind of crazy food focus and this thought of like, oh, I can eat this now, I can eat that now, because we still have the remainder of the job to do. This is just the beginning, and obviously it was a brilliant outcome yesterday, but that can't affect me mentally, and I have to just keep moving forward. Otherwise, I would really kick myself in less than 2 weeks now, getting on that two bro stage and not being able to bring my best. So that's the focus now. I think it's really important to kind of realign your focus properly after a show, whether that's, okay, now I'm into an off season, the priority is health, strength, and getting food back up, or it's, okay, now we're pushing for another show. So just remaining focused, but at the same time enjoying, you know, the fact that I'm not doing cardio this morning, but I'm still gonna keep my routine fairly similar. I'm still going out, doing some steps, fasting. I haven't eaten anything, I've just hydrated. Yeah.
The end of the first show.
Yeah. I'm just excited for the next ones, really. It's gonna be very different. Obviously, we've not competed with two bros before. It's just a different world almost. Like, the expectation of what I've got to look like is very different. So it'll be very interesting to take you guys along and to see what we can do there. You know, I know what needs to be improved. We've still probably got another like 4 pounds, I'd say, of body fat to come off. Yeah, which is doable, but that just shows how not ready I am for that show. I was obviously bob on the money. That was my feedback. Bang on the money for this show, but for the next show it's different, so we just continue to work. Later we're going to enjoy the rest of our walk, get some fresh air in.
Got this wet bench.
Yeah, get off this wet bench, things we do for YouTube. My ass is now freezing and soaked. But yeah, just thought we'd pick up the camera the morning after, just so you can see how relaxed I am, actually, because I don't know, it can...
It's quite overwhelming.
Yeah, it's a big weekend, it can be quite overwhelming, so...
She was very tired this morning, so...
Yeah, but we basically went straight to bed once my parents had gone. We tried to watch a film, and then we were just like, nah, we're going to bed. But yeah, we will see you guys a little bit later on. So from a very brown and tanned Ali, do not forget to like, comment and subscribe to this video, and thank you so much for watching. I hope that this was just one of many very, very fun show day vlogs that I've got to put together for you guys, and I will see you in the next video.